Graphene, best-known property, high conductibility. But a local team of researchers thought outside the box and came up with something quite the opposite. Kim Ji-yeon introduces to us white graphene, which actually blocks electricity and radiation.
A research team has come up with the technology for the development of white graphene that could withstand high temperatures of 900 degrees Celsius and at the same time block radiation. It's made of boron and nitrogen and is referred to as white graphene because of its color and its hexagonal form. The material is expected to be used to make suits to block radiation in space. Other likely applications include suits that accumulate electricity when heat is applied, as well as the making of radiation suits for nuclear power plants. White graphene appears to have characteristics that are the exact opposite of black graphene, which is made entirely of carbon. Unlike black graphene, which is a strong conductor of electricity used to make semiconductors, white graphene is an insulator. What they do have in common, though, is that they're both firm and flexible due to their hexagonal atomic structures. They're also very difficult to produce, which has been a major stumbling block to mass production.
We came up with an easier way to produce white graphene by applying 1,000 degrees Celsius of heat onto the nickel circuit board coated with boron nitrogen solution. The process gets rid of the original manufacture process of heating gas substances in high temperatures in an ultra-vacuum state.
The researcher says this method could help put white graphene to use in the industrial setting in the next 3 years. There are two methods to apply the white graphene coating. One is spin coating, which involves spraying the solution onto a material placed on a bending wheel. This method could ensure that the solution gets applied evenly. The other method is called spray coating, in which producers could make various wavy surfaces of the solution. In the long term, the research team says it plans to further study boron, carbon, and nitrogen elements to produce new materials that could replace the widely used metals and ceramics. Kim Ji-yeon, Arirang News.